Into the fog-covered streets of London hurry two familiar figures as they quickly hail a hansom cab, then speed on their way to another case of murder, mystery, and mayhem. This is Harry Bartell, and welcome once again for two more exciting Sherlock Holmes mysteries starring Basil Rathbone and Nigel Bruce. When I was the announcer on the 1945-1946 season of Sherlock Holmes broadcasts, radio was at its peak. I took some time recently to do a little research on just what was being sent out over the airways each evening, and I came up with some interesting information. There were more than 16 mystery shows presented each week, with The New Adventures of Sherlock Holmes being one of the most popular. That comes down to a minimum of two radio mysteries a night. Now, I'm not talking about shoot-'em-up cops and robbers type shows, but real mystery shows with carefully worked out plots, a main character the listener cared about and who solved the crime, and a lot of interesting suspects peppered in between. The Second World War was winding down and everything was still scarce. New automobiles wouldn't hit the streets until late 1946, so everyone had to make do with what they had. And a lot of what they had was old and patched up in order to work. It was such things as I've just mentioned that kept people at home conserving their money and time, and it was what made them turn to radio as the great free entertainment medium. A lot of people were mystery lovers, and it was easy to find them seated in their favorite armchair, the radio humming away beside them as they tried to outwit Bulldog Drummond, the Falcon, Mr. and Mrs. North, Michael Shane, and yes, even Sherlock Holmes. Some were experts at it. Most were not, and that always made it more enjoyable to listen to the final solution of the crime given at the end of the program. So popular were these mystery shows that in 1946, only 1 year later, there were almost double the number of mystery shows as the year before. The sad part is that it would be less than 2 years when television began appearing, effectively ending the era of the armchair detective. But oh, what a time that was. And here for a moment more, we can bring back a little of that time as we now listen to Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson in Murder in Wax.
This episode from the life of Sherlock Holmes will be transmitted to our men and women overseas by shortwave and through the worldwide facilities of the Armed Forces Radio Service. Petri Wine brings you Basil Rathbone and Nigel Bruce in The New Adventures of Sherlock Holmes. The Petri family, the family that took time to bring you good wine, invite you to listen to Dr. Watson tell us another exciting adventure he shared with his old friend, that master detective, Sherlock Holmes. Tonight, instead of joining the doctor at his home, we're all meeting here at Camp Roberts in California, where the doctor's going to tell his story before a large audience of GIs. And, as usual, I'm going to tell my story right now. It's about Petri California Sherry. And I want you to know that Petri Sherry is the best beginning a good meal ever had. Before you sit down to dinner some evening soon, just pour yourself a glass of Petri Sherry. Look at that rich, dark amber color. Just smell the fragrance of those wonderful grapes. And then taste that Petri Sherry. Is that ever good? And say, if you like your sherry on the dry side, you know, not sweet, then just wait till you taste Petri Pale Dry Sherry. If some of your family like regular sherry and some like pale dry, don't buy one, buy two. You can't go wrong so long as you buy Petri. P-E-T-R-I. Petri Sherry. And now let's join Dr. Watson and get on with our story.
Good evening, Mr. Bartell.
Well, Doctor, your study seems a little bigger than usual this week.
Yes, my boy. I felt that as tonight's new Sherlock Holmes adventure was rather an exciting one, the men here at Camp Roberts might like me to tell it to them in person.
I'm sure they will, Doctor. Which particular story have you selected?
One that I call The Strange Case of the Murder in Wax. It concerns one of the most sinister mass murderers who ever threatened the peace of London. It's in the summer of 1900, and the city had been rocked by a series of ghastly murders on Hampstead Heath.
Hampstead Heath?
Yes, Hampstead Heath. That's a large rambling park in the suburbs of London, Mr. Bartell, and noted as a rendezvous for young lovers. It was here that the elusive murderer, knife in hand, was wont to roam at nighttime, searching for his prey. All of his victims were young girls, and despite the frantic efforts of the police, each murder seemed to be as baffling as the one that preceded it. Finally, of course, as usual, Scotland Yard came to Sherlock Holmes for help. It seems almost like yesterday, Mr. Bartell, that Inspector Lestrade stood in our Baker Street rooms, imploring Holmes to handle the case.
Mr. Holmes, you've got to help us. I don't mind telling you the Yard's at the end of its rope.
I sympathize with you, Lestrade, but I don't see that there's much that I can do. Only the police can handle the widespread, detailed work necessary to this case. The private detective is helpless.
Yes, perhaps if you'd come to Mr. Holmes in the first place, Lestrade, he might have helped you.
But the murderer hasn't finished yet. There'll be more killings if we don't catch him, you mark my words. Mr. Holmes, please help us, won't you?
Before I commit myself, Lestrade, give me the exact chronology of events, will you? All my information on the murders has been derived from the London newspapers, notoriously inaccurate in matters of fact.
I can give you all the particulars, sir. I've been on the case right from the beginning. All the murders have taken place on Hampstead Heath at night time, and all the victims have been young women.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.